Hi there, I'm Dokus, and today we'll get you started with your ATOS queue. In this tutorial, I'll show you how to make a scan with the GOM Inspect suite. Feel free to pause at any point to follow along. There are also chapter segments if you wish to skip ahead. In our previous video, I showed you how to set up the complete system. Now I've put the ATOS queue on the tripod so I can easily move around if necessary. The part we will be scanning for our first scan part will be this casted part. Let's open up the software. The GOM Inspect suite always opens with the same starting page. We can start with a new project, open an existing project, or go to the recently used projects. We also have the possibility to download sample data, or go to the Get Started for more information. Let's start with a new project. The software exists out of different workspaces. The first one is a setup, where we can define which measuring volume is mounted and we can calibrate the sensor. The second one is the digitizing workspace, which we will use to digitize our part. Then we have the inspection to inspect the part, the report for editing the PDFs, and the mesh editing to play around with our scanned data. Let's go to the digitizing workspace. In the middle, you can see the measuring volume. This is created thanks to the left and the right camera, which will create a calibrated volume here, where everything which fits inside will be scanned. That volume you can see here. On the right-hand side, you see the distance radar, which will help us to position the sensor in reference to the part. Closer to the center means that it's nice in the middle of the measuring volume. Our main toolbar will help us with all the tools that we need. The first button is the selection of the scanning template. A scanning template is a predefined set of parameters which will help us to get the maximum accuracy and precision of the scan that we can make. Because we have a casted part, I will choose the scanning template Casting. Now we are ready to make our first scan. I can do that with the big yellow button below. The software automatically identifies which is the optimum exposure time to measure the part and will also automatically scan the table or the background. This result is shown here. You see that automatically everything that we don't need is cut away. So if I click on OK, I only have my part and I can continue scanning. Thanks to the reference points that I've put on the part, I can easily rotate the part and transform each next scan on the previous one with a very high accuracy. With this technology, I can just continue rotating and scanning until I have enough data captured from the top of the part. When enough data is captured, I can go to our final step. This is clicking on the finish flag, the last icon on our main toolbar. It's called Polygonizing. And this is actually combining all the different scans that we have taken. We have different angles, we have seen several planes one, two, or three times, and Polygonizing will combine all this information into one smooth STL file, which we can then use later. Here you can see the final result, one very detailed mesh. These are all the steps you need to do to make a scan. If you experience anything different from what you have seen here, or if you have any issues with your ATOS queue, please reach us via support@handsonmetrology.com. For more tutorials, please check out our tutorial videos. Thanks for watching and we'll see you next time.